Tonight. They must have taken the invitations with them. You wouldn't happen to have seen two carriages pass by here just now?
I did, sir. One with a man in it, the other with a woman. They split up.
Where did the man go?
That way.
Thank you.
You'd rather be a slave to them all your life. I won't stand for it.
Nothing's gonna slip past me.
Someone's here!
Intruder! Stay you are!
much.
Looks like a mess I should stay clear of.
Yeah. girl. Easy.
A private party event. Don't mind if I do.
Feeding your wife?
Maybe I haven't been quite as delicate as I could have been, but still. Mrs. Gladstone's under guard. Better be cautious. Better wait until she's alone. Now is my chance. One should not attend the Queen's ball without making a proper entrance.
Right in the mud.
Now for the invitations. What's this? Swords must be left at the door by order of the Queen. Freddy will know what to do.
What carriage you got there? Where did you buy it, if you don't mind me asking?
Ask all you want, Freddy. You'll never get an answer.
Damn it all. Was it my eyebrows?
Yes. And your face, voice, and body. Look, I've got an invitation to the Queen's ball tonight.
How did you come by that?
Freddy, there's to be an attack on the ball. I need to smuggle some weapons inside to prevent it.
Supposing I believe you? Only the Royal Guard carries weapons.
So?
Too easy.
For God's sake, Freddy.
Fine. I require a guard's uniform.
Done. I knew you'd come through.
Just promise me, Jacob, that you will return Mr. Gladstone's coach.
Of course.
Silence.
Supposed to be here! I'll put you down! He's here! He'll falter soon!
For help. Charming. Now to hide the body.
Ready? Here I come. One uniform as requested.
It's still warm.
My gift to you?
I will meet you on the roof of Buckingham Palace.
You're such a romantic.
Delighted to see you again, Miss Fry.
Your Highness, the plans detailing the renovations to Buckingham Palace have gone astray.
I suppose you will have to make do with the copies.
There are copies? Where?
Not so fast. First, I have a matter of some urgency. Carrying out my plan would require stealth and speed, qualities I know you possess.
Time is of the essence, Your Highness.
Then make this quick, my dear. The most influential men in Parliament remain beyond my reach. But these very men have sent for carriages to prepare for the ball tonight. Acquire an official carriage, and we shall drive the politicians to their destinations. Along the way, I will meet with them. And afterward, I shall tell you where to find the plans.
You're a shrewd negotiator.
One must be when one is so often underestimated.
Don't allow personal feelings.
joy in death, is there?
Thank you. Dead as a doornail.
There you go. Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission. What a mistake.
Thank you.
Maybe someone ought to notify the loony bin. Mind you, I heard they're paying good money at the College of Medicine. Long gone.
Easy. Atta girl. Faster! Easy girl.
Shall we lobby our cause, Miss Fry?
Climb up, Your Highness. Where are we headed?
Belgrave Square. Welcome, sir.
Your Highness, it was a surprise.
Is life not about embracing the unexpected? I shall take but a few moments of your time. A matter of utmost importance must be discussed. When the Commonwealth seized the Punjab from my people?
It was not a seizure, but a rightful transaction.
Britain promised to protect me. By robbing me of my kingdom, Parliament acted in violation of the treaty signed with my family. Here, read it.
I was not aware.
Read. That is all I ask. You are one of the few in a position to help.
I will do what I can.
Thank you, sir. I trust you and your son will enjoy the ball this evening.
He is newly returned from Delhi. I will share what we have discussed. It is most disconcerting.
Disaster avoided as flames engulfed the Alhambra Music Hall.
That proved quite valuable.
Where to now?
St. James's Park. I noticed Mr. Green did not accompany you.
He has other things to attend to.
Ah, a pity. You two seem to get along nicely.
Well, that was a problem, you see. One must not allow personal feelings to compromise one's mission.
That sounds like a quotation.
It is. From my father.
Ethan Fry.
You knew him?
No, unfortunately. But Mr. Green spoke of him. He sounded like an extraordinary man.
He was, Your Highness.
And your mother as well, Cecily Fry. She and your father were partners, inseparable. The only duo that came close to challenging Mr. Starrick. And very much in love, at least from the small amount I have been told.
Cecily, I wish I could have met her.
From what Mr. Green gathered, you share much in common. Your intelligence, for one.
Father never spoke of her. What would Mr. Green like? He was only a boy when he trained with my father.
Children can be quite perceptive, Miss Fry.
Easy.
To Parliament, please. On the floor.
Yes, sir.
Good day, sir.
Why, what are you doing here, Your Highness?
I know how busy your days have been of late. A few moments of your time is all I require.
This is all rather unorthodox, but continue.
Britain was to protect me according to the treaty my family signed. Instead, she took my land. And now I hear Britain intends to strengthen her ties to India. Perhaps it is time to return the Punjab to her people.
The Queen has supplied you with an annual income for God knows how long, and now you bite the hand that feeds you?
It is not a matter of money. I cannot stand idle and watch my homeland subjected to the yoke of an outsider's rule. My people are treated as slaves. I will...
Good day, sir.
May God bless you.
There you go.
Only one more remains. To the Gladstone residence.
Do you miss India?
I remember that my mother smelled of cinnamon. And when she cradled me in her arms in the summer heat, I would hold so still that she fell asleep. When I lost my kingdom, it hurt. For truly.
To the Zenobia Club, straight away.
Good day, Mr. Gladstone.
Mr. Singh.
You are a hard man to pin down.
I know what this is about. Your parlor tricks have worn off. Your Majesty has tired of you. So now you come begging for scraps.
You wound me deeply, sir. My people deserve freedom. I am here to fight for them.
Why did you lose the Punjab? I shall tell you, Your Highness. You were outgunned, outmaneuvered, and simply outclassed. Yes, the Sikhs deserve freedom. I hope with British help and progress, they shall achieve it.
Then why do they cry out for their king?
Britain has a duty to bring about peace. It is an enormous responsibility. And I value your guidance and advice, along with that of Parliament. But it's our burden to rule India, and certainly not the duty of a forgotten leader who has not seen his country for 20 years. Much luck, Your Highness, with your lobbying. I hope my advice has done some good.
Far more than your policies thus far. But I hold out hope that you will make progress. My people are counting on it. Thank you, Miss Fry, for forwarding my cause.
Oh, you are welcome. I hope some good comes of it, despite Mr. Gladstone's vitriol.
Those of us with the largest hearts protect them the most. Your father, for instance. From what I understand, he was extraordinarily sad, broken even, after your mother's passing. That kind of pain can blind us, cause us to say outlandish things to protect the ones we love. It's time you returned this carriage and recovered those plans.
They are located in Buckingham Palace. The Queen keeps them among her personal papers in the White Drawing Room. I wish you a good evening, Miss Evie Fryer.
And to you, Your Highness.
Evie, nice to see you again.